revisit the songs and make them feel really modern and part of the world around us. And I really don't think we had to work that hard, because the songs still feel kind of pretty now to me. And even in the themes, here's a song that we wrote about a lot of our friends way back in the 1970s who were forced to join the army to try and get a job. And then they ended up in some terrible place they didn't want to be. That's very pertinent to our times. It's called Melancholy Soldiers.
Thank you.
About 4 or 5 years ago, and again it was a story that kind of caught the mood of the time that we were living in the 1970s, very strange period, and our friends who were going off to these terrible places never came back, some of them, and I wrote this song as a kind of imaginary conversation between a kid telephoning their dead father. this song to anybody who's lost somebody very, very dear to them. That includes myself, my own father. It was recently covered by two wee bands, and I think we did an okay job with it. It's called The Shades of Coming.
Oh,
It's odd how you wrote a song many, many years ago, and in a strange kind of way, it's reinvented. I remember when we first wrote the next song, and it was not a song that I particularly liked very much. But then, this guy here, Bruce Watson, along with Mike and Bill, really got the song by the throat and gave it a shake. And when I came into the first rehearsal, I couldn't believe it. It's now my favourite Skid song. It's called The Olympian. Sophisticated musicians, and I said to them, either I become the singer in this band or I'm going to kick your fat arse. So apologies for the fact I can't sing, apologies for the fact I can't dance, but hey, what the hell, here I am, okay? This is another bit of Adamson magic, the first ever song we ever wrote in a little back street garage up in Wellwood. And I think it still resonates today. A song called Charles. Yeah! Apologies for the mistake for those who noticed. Who noticed? Damn, everybody. Okay, another one really from the baggy tricks from the old days. Well, not baggy tricks from the old days, but from the really old days. A song called Out of Town.
Oh!
The song also captured the mood of what it was like living in West Fife in the 1970s. It was a very violent time and very scary if you were a little bit different. And trust me, Bill Simpson, Stuart Adamson and the then Tom Kellyken, we looked different and it was really dangerous and scary. And Stuart Adamson wrote this wonderful song about it. It's called Scared to Dance. This is a song about never quite knowing the person who's standing right next to you, what they've been through. It's a song called Hurry On Boys. merits of this damn fine chap here. William Simpson, born in Mochelli, 1874. How about that? 104 years old, now look at him. I won't tell you what he takes. I'm going to take to you. Okay. Sorry, folks. That was very naughty. It's a damn fine specimen of humanity. Let's give him a round of applause. We're fifers, believe it or not, and we're very proud of it. And sometimes I've been guilty of being a bit of a tosser, so I make a public apology tonight. Please accept it. I never meant it. Anyway, here we go. We're on the final hurdle. Charades. He's ever had, Mr. Mike Bailey. And definitely this time on rhythm guitar, Mr. Bill Simpson. Come on. I've been winding him up for the past 5 weeks, poor guy, and he just cannot wait till Sunday till he sees the back of me. Is that right, Bill? Okay, here we go. A song called Circus Games. Over the other stage, the outdoor stage, way back in 1977, where we did a benefit gig for the Communist Party in aid of Chilean refugees. And we started our second song, and Stuart Adamson said, "If you were in a communist country, you would literally stand there and watch us." End of gig. So, they didn't do that to us tonight, but I guess maybe the politics play with Stuart. And we were just the idiots. I don't know. Anyway, here's one that I hope you love as much as I do. A song called Masquerade. Yeah! finished the walk, a boy shouldn't have been. His name was Alex Harvin. We're a band called the Sensational Alex Harvin Band. The first ever real punk band in Scotland, I think. And this is Fambo.
Thank you.
Good things come to those who wait. And they're going to wait a long time.
Yeah.
Thank you.